Did you know Anquan was wavering about playing football, Kurt?
Well, I knew he was wavering. I'd actually had some conversations with him leading up to the Hall of Fame because I wanted him to come down and join me, and he was just contemplating as he went farther and farther into the off season and no deal really done, whether this was going to be the time where he decided to hang it up or not. And then hadn't really had any conversations with him since he signed his deal with Buffalo. So knowing that he was wavering and then signing the deal, I kind of thought, okay, he's at least going one more year. Haven't really had a chance to talk to him since he made that decision. I texted him yesterday and just congratulated him on a great career, but wasn't fully sure on what led to this decision after signing that contract. But I know it's been hard on him and his family the last few years as he left Arizona, and it seemed like he was bouncing all over with different teams. And and that's so important to him, to make sure that his family's with him and he gets to spend time with them and that they're a priority. And so I'm sure a lot of that played into this decision, but definitely was surprised after he signed the contract that he decided to pack it up.
And when did you first meet him? Just when you strolled in from the Giants? Was that the first time
exactly.
you met him?
Yeah, exactly. I didn't know a whole lot about him. And, one of the stories, Josh McCown was a guy I knew that was here in Arizona when I came. And I was coming from St. Louis, obviously, via the stop in New York. And, and Josh kept texting me and telling me, hey, Anquan, you're going to love Anquan. He's just like Torrey Holt. And, here I am. I'm sitting here with a future Hall of Famer and going, okay, that's high praise, but, I'm gonna reserve myself to really see that because there's not very many guys that are like Torrey Holt. And when I got here, I saw exactly what he was talking about, the pro that he was, the ability to do so many different things, unbelievable competitiveness. I don't know if I ever played with a guy that was more competitive than Anquan Boldin. Just a pro's pro. And, it's funny because we actually had conversations when I was here, so that was, however many years ago, 7 years ago or more, with Anquan going, how long are you going to play? And at that time, Anquan was a guy that was very self-conscious that life was so much bigger than football. And I remember when he was here thinking, he could retire at any moment and be 100% fine. Some guys, it's like, this is all I really know. I'm going to play until they kick me out. Anquan, I've kind of waited every time that his contract has been up somewhere. I've texted him. I'm like, all right, is this it? And he goes, I'm not really sure yet. And so I always appreciated that about him because he was very conscious of the community and his family and things beyond football that he loved football and loved to compete and was gifted to do it. But it was never the thing that, that drove him to the point where he had to do it. And so I've been waiting for this, this moment for a long time going, okay, he'll go back and play or he won't. And he's going to be 100% fine either way. And it won't surprise me either way. And that's just kind of the guy he was. And so I look forward to seeing what he does next because he's not going to be the guy that sits on his couch. He's going to go out and make a difference and continue to make a difference across the country, and I'm excited to see what he chooses to do next.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on radio stations across the country and audience.
If you like that, download our app. Please, just if it's a memory thing, just delete other apps. You don't need those apps. This app, the Rich Eisen Show app, you need that.